Hello everyone. Greetings from NVPS Academy. Stay home, stay safe. Today we are going to discuss about from IIT Mathematics, 8th class and from 9th class, sets. Set theory was introduced by George Cantor. So what is meant by a set? A well-defined collection of the objects is called a set. Otherwise, a well-defined collection of the elements is called a set. What is meant by well-defined? So, in a set, every element satisfying the same property, and also every element belonging to that set. So, sets are represented with capital alphabets like capital A, capital B, capital C. So, these sets have within the curly braces separated with commas. For example, I have considered here set A. Set A is equal to within the curly braces 1, 2, 3. It is a set. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 are well-defined objects or well-defined elements. How can we say? So these are natural numbers from 1 to 4. And also every element belonging to this set. Every element belonging to this set. We call this is the belongs to. So 5 also a natural number, but it does not belongs to set A. So that's why well-defined collection of objects or well-defined collection of elements nothing but each element having the same property and also each element belonging to that set. Next, representation of sets. Representation of sets. Generally, sets are represented in two ways. One is roster form. Second one is set builder form. In roster form, generally, within the curly braces, the elements are separated with commas. See, for example, so this is the roster form. So I want to take another one. A equal to AEIOE. These are vowels in the alphabets. So separated with the comma. This is roster form. Now set builder form. In set builder form, the elements satisfying the property or a rule. The elements are satisfying the property or a rule. So what is that rule? So here we are writing the property just set of vowels in alphabets. So this is the condition or this is the property or this is the rule. So in set builder form, we are writing the property or rule for the given set. So this is the set builder form. One more example. I want to consider A equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So now it is in roster form. Set builder form. Set of vowel numbers less than or equal to 4. Set of vowel numbers less than or equal to 4. So we are writing like this. Set of whole numbers less than or equal to 4. Okay, otherwise we can write in this manner. X such that X belongs to W. So small w belongs to capital W. So this is small w belongs to less than or equal to 4. So this is the set builder form. Now we are going to see types of the sets. Next, in this we are going to discuss types of the
sets. So here types of the sets started from finite, infinite, singleton, empty, universal, subset, power set. So one by one I am going to write and I am going to explain those.
Observe here carefully.
So first one is finite set.
What is meant by a finite set? A finite set is nothing but consisting of countable number of elements.
See, for example, set C equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So these are countable. A set consisting of countable number of elements is called finite set.
Second one, infinite set. What do you mean by infinite set?
A set consisting of uncountable number of elements.
So best example, natural numbers, set of natural numbers and so on, there is no ending, uncountable. Next, set of whole numbers, uncountable. Next, set of integers and so on, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and so on.
So these are best examples for the infinite set. Next, singleton set.
What is meant by singleton set?
A set consisting only one element,
that is called singleton set. Singleton 1, singleton 2, singleton 3.
So these are the best examples for the singleton set. Next, empty set.
Empty set.
Empty set, there are no elements. The set doesn't contain any element.
So simply we are representing empty curly braces or symbol phi.
What we call the symbol phi.
Next, universal set.
Universal set. Universal set is the superset of all sets. If we consider any sets, any number of sets, there is a universal set, means it is a superset of all sets. For example, we are considering here, so universal set is represented with mu.
So mu symbol can be written as like this. So this is mu. I am considering here universal set as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next, A equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3, B equal to 4 comma 5 comma 6, C equal to 7 comma 8 comma 9 comma 10.
So these are all sets and this is a universal set. So this universal set is a superset of all these sets because the elements of these three sets contained in mu. So that's why
mu is superset of A, mu is superset of B, mu is superset of C.
So that's why, and also we reverse, we have to take as A is subset of mu, B is subset of mu, C is subset of mu. That means A contained in superset, B contained in superset, C contained in superset. So superset means reverse we are going to take, subset means opposite direction. Okay, so this is the meaning. Next, we are going to discuss about subsets.
Subset.
What is meant by subset? Now only we discussed it.
subset. If A and B are any two non-empty sets, all elements in A also contained in B, then A is a subset of B. For example, A equal to A comma B, B equal to A comma B comma C, then A is a subset of B because all elements in A contained in B. Sometimes we are taking equal to when containing same elements. So these are also called as equal sets. What we call this? Equal sets. Next, so this is subset. Next concept is proper subsets. Now we are going to take proper subsets. Proper subsets. What is meant by a proper subset? So a set contains n number of elements, then it has 2 power n minus 1 number of elements. Okay, this much of proper sets it has. For example, I want to take set A is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3. That means 2 cube minus 1, that is equal to 7. So how many proper sets it has? 7 proper sets. Now we are going to write one by one. Set 1, singleton 1, singleton 2, singleton 3, 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3, 2 comma 3. So finally 1 comma 2 comma 3. So every set is a subset of itself also. So that's why we have to write finally 1 comma 2 comma 3. So how many, sir, how many subsets we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it has tally. So that's why proper set is nothing but if a set contains n number of elements, then it has 2 power n minus 1 number of proper subsets. So here I have taken one example, A equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3. That means 2 cube minus 1, that is equal to 7. So the proper sets, the proper subsets going to take as 1, singleton 1, singleton 2, singleton 3, next 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3, 2 comma 3, finally itself of the set. So every set is a subset itself. Next, power set. Power set. Power set. There is a slight difference between proper subsets and power set. A set contains n number of elements, then it has 2 power n subsets. For example, before example we have taken like A equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3. So now we are going to write a power set. That means 2 power n sets we are going to write. That means 2 cube, that is equal to 8. So here we are going to write singleton 1, singleton 2, singleton 3, next 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3, 2 comma 3, 1 comma 2 comma 3. So finally empty set. Empty set is a subset for all sets. Empty set is a subset for all sets. So that's why we have taken here. So how many subsets we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So this is about the power set. Next, disjoint sets. Disjoint. Disjoint means there is no join. Disjoint. Next. Disjoint sets. There are no common elements in the given sets. Such a type of sets are called disjoint sets. So for example, here A equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3, B equal to A comma B comma C. Are there any common elements? So that's why these two sets are called disjoint sets. So these are the types of the sets.
and this is the simple introduction about the sets. Thank you so much.